So good afternoon, everybody. So I will try to summarize mainly the main achievements that we have already done during the last year in the project LEADER, and how LEADER is contributing to building free, interlinked, and interoperable language resources. So you already know it was presented several 1 year ago, and also in several roadmapping workshops. In LEADER, we have three kind of activities. The first one is the community building activities, which is performed through three different working groups at W3C. The first one is the Lean Data for Language Technologies. The second one are the best practices for publishing multilingual link open data. And the third one is the Ontolex working group, where they are proposing the model. We also have the industry use cases, which are collecting requirements from foreign users. And we have some technical activities which consist in providing vocabularies, guidelines, roadmaps, and a reference architecture. And these technical activities that we are producing in LEADER are input to the community building network. So everything is now open and being discussed in the three W3C groups. For those people that are not following LEADER, LEADER is about linguistic linked license data. So this means that we are providing language resources like lexica, corpora, and dictionaries. We are transforming them into RDF using models like Lemon for lexica and NIF for corpora. All these resources are licensed in the sense that we are also expressing in RDF the license information using ODRL. This is the evolution of how the linguistic link data was before LEADER in January 2013, how it was in September 2013 with more language resources data sets in RDF. In September 2014, it evolves with more than 60 resources already integrated. And now you have seen the new cloud in the booth, where we have now many terminologies, thesauri, knowledge bases already included, coming, for instance, from the Apertium. BabelNet is taking now a central role in this linguistic link data cloud. So this is a bit bigger, just in case you want to find your resources. In addition to the generation of some of the resources by consortium members, we are providing best practices and guidelines for multilingual link data publication, and also guidelines for linguistic link data licensing. In that particular case, for WordNets, multilingual lexicography, bilingual dictionaries, terminology in TVX, and also for corpora. So you can take some of these reference cards in one of the tables, which is out of this meeting room. And at this moment, all these building reference cards are being discussed and being agreed in the context of the best practice multilingual link open data group at W3C. In this context, we have also created models for metadata and data annotation. This activity is being carried out in the context of the link data for language technology group. So we have built a metadata OWL ontology, which is based on the Universidad Pompeu Fabra MetaShare MetaModel, and this ontology has been expanded with provenance and license information. During this design process, one of the goals was to have this backward compatibility with the original models. So then we have also exposure all the MetaShare Clarin error map and data have metadata. And we have represented all this metadata that were stored in all these different repositories. We have been described according to the metadata OWL ontology. And on top of that, we have built LinkHub, which is a tool that helps you to search language resource based on this metadata. So LinkHub is an aggregator of the metadata coming from the different metadata repositories. So just in case, if you want to try LinkHub, John Marais is around here, so he can make a demo. And now, LEADER and Philip is going to explain the roadmap and the reference architecture.
So as Asuna said, one important aspect of the Leader Project is to foster the publication, reuse, and discovery of linguistic resources. And to understand the current and future needs of stakeholders, the Leader Project has engaged in roadmapping exercises. So we have created a roadmap that foresees what kind of developments are needed to foster the uptake and exploitation of linguistic resources in the future. And for this, to understand these needs, we've carried out a number of so-called roadmapping workshops in the last 3 years and aggregated all these findings in a roadmap document that has been produced as a deliverable of the project. That includes the perspective of a number of companies, resource providers, but also of people active in the relevant community groups, W3C community groups that you see here. So overall, we think that our roadmap summarizes the perspective of hundreds of relevant stakeholders in this field. And we've grouped use cases in this roadmap along those three lines that you see here. One is a business line, which is about global customer engagement use cases. The other is a public sector threat, where we look at how to increase the reuse of public sector information. And finally is about workflows or value change involving linguistic linked data, resources, and services. The predictions we make in the roadmap span a horizon of short-term, 3 years, mid-term, 4, 5 years, and long-term, 10 years. So we invite you to look at this roadmap and give us feedback on it. Building on the identified needs, the Leader Project has created a reference architecture that is supposed to support the process of publishing and using linguistic resources published as linked data. So at the bottom line, you have the existing data sets that exist, corpora, terminologies, translation memories. On top of that, it's important to publish not only the data itself, but also general metadata, information about licensing condition, information about provenance, and the Leader Project makes guidelines and recommendations available to anyone wanting to provide this information. Those who have been at the booth have seen the reference cards that we've developed that are supposed to be small recipes to be followed when describing all this relevant information. On top of that, we have a publishing layer that makes recommendations and provides guidelines on vocabularies, for example, for publishing linguistic data as linguistic linked data sets. And the same for services. So if you want to provide a service over those data sets, we also have a number of recommendations and guidelines for that layer. On top of that, the actual benefit of linked data is that resources are not only published in isolation, but they are linked to each other. So the project also gives recommendations on, well, which sort of best practices to follow when linking different data sets and how this process can be to some extent automatized. We've seen an example of this in the presentation this morning of Roberto when he talked about how to link YATE and other terminologies to BabelNet. On top of that, very important is the discovery layer because those who want to use resources, they need to be able to find them. So LingHub that has been introduced by Asun already is our reference implementation of the discovery layer. And we show how we can aggregate resources from different places and provide one unique entry point to search for linguistically relevant data sets. On top, there are two layers that the Leader Project has not yet sort of completely spelled out or where there's no yet major reference implementation, but I want to mention them because in a landscape in which many services and data sets coexist, it's important to provide independent benchmarking services that help people in choosing that resource that fits best their purpose. And also we'll need some organizations that are able to certify that certain data sets meet certain quality levels. So certification is an important layer in the architecture. I want to stress that we're involved in the relevant standardization activities. We build on open standards. So this architecture is supposed to be an open architecture where there's no proprietary formats, no vendor lock-in. And I think this is very important because only then we are sure to implement an architecture and solution that will work for everybody without major restrictions. Okay, so with that we close. Thanks a lot for your attention. Here are the relevant links and please give us your feedback now or offline on the roadmap and other aspects of the project. Thanks a lot.